Those that know it and you want to stand and sing it with us, it's okay.
Church choir, you can stand right where you are. Song says, I do. Oh, no, no, yes.
Let's say that again.
I really do.
I would like to say good evening to everyone tonight. We pray that you had a blessed and successful day today. We thank you for tuning in tonight. Every Wednesday night at 8 o'clock, you have Restoring Souls to Christ radio show. In just a few minutes, we will hear the woman of God, your radio host, Pastor Brenda D. Wilson. Amen. Let somebody know we're here. Share this on your Facebook page. Invite your neighbors and your friends to listen to this radio ministry. And we pray that something said, something heard, bless you in a mighty way. God bless you, and we'll be right back.
We'll bless your name for your goodness and your glory.
All right, come on, let's give the woman of God a hand clap. Come on.
From me to you, Lord, hallelujah. From me to you, Lord, thank you, Jesus, for all you've done and all you do. For every time, Lord, you brought me through, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, from me to you. From me to you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, from me to you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for all you've done and all you do. And every time, Lord, you brought me through. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, from me to you. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Good evening and welcome to the Restoring Souls to Christ broadcast. I'm your host, Pastor Brenda D. Wilson from Duncanville, Texas. Thank you for joining us tonight. And we're going to begin our service with prayer. Go with me. Father God, in the name of Jesus, because of who you are tonight, Lord, we give you glory. And because of who you are, God, we give you praise. I thank you for this opportunity to come before your presence tonight and to bring your word to your people for such a time as this. I pray that they be blessed and that they have a listening ear. In the mighty name of Jesus, bless your people. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. I thank the Lord on tonight. And we're going to go directly into our scripture. And it will be coming from St. Matthew 25, beginning at the first verse. And it reads, then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry made, behold, the bridegroom coming. Go ye out to meet him. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, Give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered, saying, Not so, lest there be not enough for us and you. But go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourselves. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. Afterwards came also the other virgins, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said, Verily I say unto you, I know you not. Watch therefore, for ye know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh. This is a very familiar scripture, and it's an awesome parable to let us know that we should all be ready. And in this parable, it was seen there was a wedding was getting ready to take place. Now, I would think that the participants knew about the wedding ahead of time. Let your mind see this as a natural wedding, and go with me for a little while. Now, there were 10 people in this wedding party. Everyone received that invitation at the same time. Everyone was informed of what they needed to wear, from the color of their dresses, their shoes, to the type of jewelry they needed to wear. Well, the bridegroom was going to get himself prepared and to get the mansion ready for his bride. But it was seen that there was a delay in the ceremony because everyone didn't come to the rehearsal prepared. Half of them were wise and even brought some extra things, such as their oil, in case of emergency, and the other half were foolish and waited to the last minute and realized they did not have everything they needed. And just like in the natural, some of us come unprepared. So it is in the spiritual. The foolish thought they could borrow some of what they lacked from the wise. They thought they could borrow some of the wise prayers to get by. They thought they could borrow some of their power to get by. They even thought they could copy their dance and get by. They even thought they could get by with borrowing some of their anointing, but not so, because they had the same opportunity as the wise ones to get everything they needed. And when they realized they didn't have what they needed, they tried to go somewhere and buy it, but it was too late. When they returned to the wedding, they were locked out. What I want to share with you concerning this parable is we must have our own personal relationship with the Lord, because I can't ride in on your coattail and you can't ride in on mine. I can't depend on your anointing, your prayer life, your praise. I have to work out my own salvation with fear and trembling. I can't even get upset with you if I call you for prayer and I can't reach you. I need to know Jesus for myself, because sometimes God will remove our crutches. Sometimes he will allow people not to be there for us all the time, so we have to depend totally on him. I can say this because I'm talking to myself. Even though my title may be pastor, my name is still Brenda, and I'm still an imperfect human trying to serve a perfect God and trying to help someone else along the way. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Now, don't misunderstand me. We do need each other, but I'm learning on some journeys we have to walk alone in the natural, but know that the Lord is with us through it all. And when we feel so alone, he's right there. I tell the people sometimes that what I give you is what, there's a conversation that has gone on between me and my Father, and we wanted to share it with you to let you know what's going on. So this was another conversation I had with my Father, and we wanted to share it with you. I was trying to throw a pity party for myself because, you know, it was like, woe is me, this ain't right, this ain't happening. But the Lord reminded me that if I stand the test, there will be glory after this. So I'm encouraged today because I was reminded of some promises God made to me. But I have to choose how long it takes for me to get what he has for me. I have to seek him for myself. I want to let you know today that this is a very wise thing to get in right standing with the Lord for yourself. Because on Judgment Day, when we stand before him, we can't blame anybody but ourselves if our name isn't written in the book of life. We can't depend on anyone to get us in the wedding feast. We have to have a personal relationship with the bridegroom to get in the gate. So be wise and prepared now for eternity with the Lord, because we need this. We need the Lord. We can't depend on somebody, our mother's prayers or our grandma's prayers. We've got to have a personal relationship with our Father. We've got to be ready when he calls our name. So I just wanted to let you know that God has us here for each other, but we can't depend on each other to get into heaven. It's a life to be led. It's a lifestyle. We have to know Jesus for ourselves. We can't depend on somebody else to hold our hands, to pat us on the back and say, it's going to be all right, baby. We have to be wise and prepare ourselves. Now, if you notice, the scripture tells us that these were 10 virgins. And in my mind's eye, virgins mean they were clean. They were saved, but all 10 of them did not receive or seek the Holy Spirit. They were saved, but the 5 foolish were saved, but they did not seek the Holy Spirit to have the anointing to flow in their life. That connection that they would have with the Lord when the trumpet sound or when it was time for the wedding feast. So when the bridegroom, when the shout came at midnight that the bridegroom was coming, when it came at midnight, the ones that got saved and had received the Holy Spirit and could feel the unction in their spirit when the bridegroom came, they went in. But the others was like, well, can we have some of y'all oil? Can y'all pray for us right quick that we can get in the wedding? Or could you give me a necklace that I left my necklace on the table at the house and I didn't bring the right color shoes. I picked up the wrong color shoes for the wedding. Can we borrow a pair of your shoes? Because the wise came prepared with extra stuff. They were prepared. They had a fresh anointing. They had the Holy Spirit moving in their body. That even when they were sleeping, waiting for the groom and preparing themselves for the groom to come, that when the call was made, they were able to get up quickly and go to the wedding feast. But the ones that were foolish and thought, okay, we say we're good, we got this, we're gonna be ready, so we're gonna take a nap too. They were very unprepared. The 5 foolish were very unprepared. They got saved, but they didn't get delivered. They didn't get the Holy Spirit. They didn't refresh their anointing. They didn't have a prayed up life. So they had to run and try to get back to the church and see if just use this in your mind's eye. They had to go back and see if they could get the pastor to pray them through. They had to go back and see if they could get this done so they could go back to the wedding and have the right dress clothes on to get back into the wedding feast. But when they got back, it was too late. The door was shut. And they said, Lord, let us in. We saved too. Didn't we cast out demons in your name? Didn't we pray for the sick? Didn't we heal the sick? And didn't we raise the dead in your name? Didn't we do all of this? But the Lord is going to say, I knew you not. I don't know you. You have those gifts. I've given you gifts without repentance. So yes, you caused people to come to me. Yes, you gave a sermon that drew people to me. Yes, you prayed for people and they were healed because I gave you that gift. But when that was over, what kind of life did you live? Were you living foolishly or were you living wisely? Did you seek my Holy Ghost? Did you live a life that was morally correct in my sight? Were you in right standing with me when you were not around the church people? Were you being wise or were you being foolish? Think about it. Are you ready for the wedding? Are you ready? Are you prepared for the wedding? Are you prepared for the bridegroom to come and say, I do? I do know you. Well done, my good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of the Lord. Come in and take a seat in your mansion that I went away to prepare for you. Are you wise or are you foolish? Did you just get saved and thought that was going to be all of that? We have salvation. We have to work at our own soul salvation with fear and with trembling. We have to be led of the, we need the Holy Spirit so that we can be led by the Holy Spirit. So that when God gives us an unction or he warns us about something in our spirit, we'll feel the quickening. We have to be wise and not foolish. So when you get saved, if this is your first journey with the Lord, or if you have backslid and want to get back to God, when you come back to him this time in the name of Jesus, if this is your second time, or whether this is your first time and you want to come to him, be wise. Seek his Holy Spirit, because that's your keeper. That's what keeps you wanting to do right. That's what speaks to your spirit. Don't do that. That's the old you. Because the word of God declares when a man comes to Christ, he's behold, he's a new creature. All things pass away and all things become new. So when you get salvation, when you give your heart, your life, your soul, your mind, your entire being to Jesus, you glorify him, you magnify him in spirit and in truth, because he told us in his word that if we worship him, we must worship him in spirit and truth. Let's be wise. Let's seek God. Let's seek his Holy Spirit. Because Jesus said when he was down here with the disciples, his word declares that I go away to prepare a place for you, but I won't leave you comfortless. I'm going to send a comforter that will be the Holy Spirit. That when you're going through what you're going through, the Holy Spirit can bring my word back to your remembrance. It can refresh your remembrance to let you know that I'm with you always. It'll refresh your remembrance to let you know that if I've done it before, I can do it again. It will refresh your remembrance to let you know you are fearfully and wonderfully made by me. You were molded and made to worship me. You were created to worship me. The Holy Spirit will remind you. So that's where the foolish version, even though they got saved, maybe they were not taught in their church that when you get saved, you need to seek the Holy Spirit, because that's your keeping power. That'll keep you from doing the same thing you used to do. It'll keep you wanting to have your mind transformed into to a mind of Christ, to serve him, to do what's pleasing to him. And if you do slip and fall, that you'll have the conscience to come back to him, ask him to forgive you with a sincere heart, and move on. That's what the wisdom of the Holy Spirit will help you do. So let's not be like the foolish version and just get saved and hold on to that. Or if I get saved and have mother so-and-so in my corner praying for me, that's how I'm going to get to heaven. I can relax and be at ease because mother so-and-so, a bishop so-and-so, a pastor so-and-so is going to be praying for me, and that's what's going to take me through. No, 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 no. My brothers and my sisters, we need the Holy Spirit, the wisdom of the Holy Spirit to carry us through. Glory to God. Thank you, God. This thing cut off. My Lord. Glory to God. So we have to know in our knower that God has us. We have to know in our knower that God's Holy Spirit is going to quicken us. That's where wisdom comes in. That's how we know that we're with the five wise virgins. That when the bridegroom comes at midnight, we'll be ready. We won't be getting ready. We'll be already ready when he calls. We won't be left behind. All our work will not be in vain. When we get to the gate, he won't say, I don't know you. because that will be a sad day when you have done all you know to do and you miss out on heaven by being foolish, by having been saved and not realizing you need the Holy Spirit to keep you. That's your oil. That's what keeps you up. That's what keeps you ready, the Holy Spirit. So the word of God declares, first seek ye the kingdom of God and all of his righteousness, and all these other things will be added unto you. So let's seek him. Let's be wise. Let's not be foolish. Let's not think that if we get saved, we're going to be all right till Jesus come. We need a keeper. Once we get saved, we need a keeper. Because the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy everything we set out to do for the Lord. So I want to say to you on today, let's not be foolish. Let's be ready when the bridegroom comes. Let's seek the Holy Spirit. Ask God to direct us how to seek him. And cry out. And say, Lord, I want to be ready when you call my name. I want to be ready when the trumpet sounds. And they say, behold, the bridegroom cometh. For I do know that Jesus is on his way back. He's on his way back. And it's closer today than it was yesterday. It's closer this minute than it was the minute before. Jesus is on his way back. So people of God, let's be wise. Let's be wise and seek God like never before in the name of Jesus. So that's what I have for you for tonight. And I pray that you were blessed by the word. I pray that something that I said blessed you or encouraged you or let you know that if you have fallen, if you have slipped, if you have not even received Jesus as your personal Savior as of yet, that there's still time. There's still time. So right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for your word on tonight. I thank you for blessing your people to hear your word on tonight. So, and I pray that some soul will cry out, what must I do to be saved? And God, I ask that you bless the listeners of this word on tonight. In Jesus' name, I pray. I thank you for listening and joining us on tonight. I pray that you could be back with us on next Wednesday night, the same time at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, in the name of Jesus, at 7 p.m. Central Time. I pray that if you want to get in contact with us, that you would drop us a line at Restoration, conlfmin.love@yahoo.com. Again, that's Restoration, conlfmin.love@yahoo.com. Or you can contact us by phone at 919-391-6250. That number again, 919-391-6250. In closing, I would like to thank our sponsor, CT Management Solutions, located in Newport News, Virginia. Phone number 757-272-4885. Again, 757-272-4885. And I would also like to give thanks to Pastor Accurate and the TMA radio station for allowing us the space and time. And until next time, good night and God bless.
You have been listening to Restoring Souls to Christ radio show. Your host was Pastor Brenda D. Wilson. You can find her here every Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We pray that the word of God, the message on this evening, bless you in a mighty way. Let somebody know that we're here. Let somebody know that someone is teaching and preaching the word of God, encouraging God's people. Again, that was Restoring Souls to Christ radio broadcast, and the host was Pastor Brenda D. Wilson. Share this broadcast on your Facebook, your Twitter, Instagram, any social media page that you have. And again, we thank you and we love you, and continue to enjoy the music on this radio station. Also, we want to remind you, in just in the coming up 30 minutes from now, 9 o'clock, we have Man to Man Talk Back, the Talk Up Show, with your host Pastor Nino and co-host Pastor Carl Young. Tonight we're talking about finances. You know, a lot of us are in financial issues, situations, and we need to be educated on how to become free from a lot of things that we're dealing with concerning finances. We have a special guest on tonight, a business owner and a man that's very knowledgeable of financial freedom. And if you need financial freedom, I want to invite you back at 9 o'clock, where we will be talking and discussing financial freedom. And we have a scripture that we will base this whole conversation on, and we'll give you that at 9 o'clock. So join us at 9, and again, we thank you for tuning in tonight at 8, and we pray that you enjoyed this message show, that you would share it to your neighbors and your friends and your family, co-workers, and all. And continue to invite people to listen to this radio station each and every week, Sunday through Thursday night. God bless you, and may heaven smile upon you.
Come on, wrap your arms around yourself. When nobody else cared about you, he was there late in the midnight. Lord, I love you. Why you don't move? Yes, I do, Lord Jesus. I really do love him, I be.
Yes, I do.
Lord, I love it.
Heavy and I'm breaking down. I wanna make it over, but I don't know how. My heart is screaming and my faith is gone. I'm barely breathing, but I'm holding on.
I'm so broken,
numb to the pain.
Lifeless, hopeless,
I feel ashamed.
Nothing, no one
can seem to break these chains. I just need about two or three to help me call his name. Oh,
pray for me, pray for me.
I feel like giving up right now.
Pray for me, pray for me.
Lord, spare your child.
Pray for me, pray for me.
I need to know that someone cares.
Pray for me, pray for me.
Standing in the need of prayer. Don't need the money, I need your help. I feel my life is ending, I need your prayer. Cause somebody call on Jesus to save me from myself. I've never been here before, please help me.
I'm so broken,
numb to the pain.
Lifeless, hopeless,
I feel so ashamed. Seem to break these chains. I just need about two or three. Help me call his name. Oh,
pray for me, pray for me.
I feel like giving up right now.
Pray for me, pray for me.
Lord, please spare your child.
Pray for me, pray for me.
I need to know that someone cares.
Pray for me, pray for me.
Standing in the need of prayer. I can't see my way. You've always been right there. Somebody
Does anybody know my heart?
I know a someone out there that's listening to the song.
Does anybody
right now?